Hey guys, my name is Alyssa Dye. I'm a recent graduate from UNL with a degree in Agriculture Education Leadership. I just graduated in May 2015 and I'm now working on building the business that I started through the Engler Entrepreneurship Program.
In May of 2014, 8 other UNL students and myself experienced a 3-week study tour in the West Africa country of Benin, focused on cat culture and agriculture in a developing country. Dr. Peterson is an agricultural economics professor at UNL who leads this program. He was a Peace Corps volunteer in Benin from 1968 to 1970. I have learned so much from him through this class and on this trip, and he has continued to be a mentor and resource for me since then. Boris Medetinsa is a Beninois entrepreneur with a West African agritourism business. He handled all of our in-country logistics and proved to be a great friend as well. He definitely went above and beyond to set up opportunities for us to cross things off our bucket list as we continued to put things on them as we went throughout Benin. We traveled around the country in 2 vans, we stayed in different hotels, and we ate at a lot of different restaurants featuring both African and European style food. Early in the study tour, we visited Gambier, which is a village of about 20,000 people built on stilts in a shallow lagoon just inland from the coastal city of Cotonou in Benin. It's an absolutely gorgeous village in the middle of a lagoon, and as you can imagine, that means no running water and no electricity. However, it was fascinating to see people go about their business paddling in dugout canoes. There's an incredible story of the history of Gambier, but you'll have to go there yourself to figure out what that one is. We visited the palaces of the kings of Dahomey, where we learned more about the kingdom's history. We also visited a Portuguese fort, which is now currently a museum on the coastal city of Ouidah. The history of southern Benin is very much shaped by the Voodoo religion and the slave trade. Throughout this entire trip, Boris explained the main ideas of this religious worldview, which is much more than sticking pins into dolls, as we know as today's voodoo. We did visit the Python Temple in Ouidah, which is a very important Voodoo religious site, and attended a demonstration in dancing and magic performed by the Zigbeto, that are the spirits of the afterlife that serve as a traditional police to keep the peace in these different communities. On the first day of the program, we visited the labs and fields of Africa Rice, which is an international agriculture research center focused on rice in Africa, as well as the Benin branch of the International Institute of Tropical Agriculture, or the IITA. Scientists from both of these organizations explained their work on rice breeding, biological control of pests, post-harvest technologies, and the economics of agricultural production in Africa. We also visited the Songhai Sustainability Center in Porto Novo to learn about the center's efforts to promote sustainable and integrated agricultural production. This was definitely one of my favorite parts of the trip. We toured the production side with the different crops, livestock, and aquaculture, and how it is involved in a synergetic production system. Their processing and manufacturing is all done within this village with machines that they built on site with recycled materials. They package everything for use that they make in Sade to be used in that village, but also to be shipped around Benin. Throughout the entire trip, we kept finding the Songhai bottled jus d'ananas, which is pineapple juice, mango juice, and babaoa juice, as well as water that is processed and filtered there. Agritourism is also a huge piece of the Songhai model. There is a hotel and a restaurant on site to bring tourists in and available tourists to share the work and the story of what Songhai is doing with everybody else. There's a leadership academy there to train and support other leaders from around the world to implement these initiatives in other rural communities, as well as a media library to be accessed worldwide, sharing their story of the things that they found through the processes and experiences that is happening at the Songhai Center. Later in the trip, we visited the processing facilities of a producer co-op that works with low-income women to produce plants from which essential oils can be extracted, and to gather seeds from the neem tree from which an oil is used for insecticidal and medicinal uses. We toured a cashew processing plant as well that ships raw cashew nuts to Europe and the United States. We spent a lot of time on the road, which means the occasional picnics. We visited local markets around Benin to see what kinds of agricultural products are produced and how they are traded. One of the highlights of our trip was the Pinjarra National Park, where we saw lions, elephants, hippopotamuses, buffalo, and more on different safaris. On the edge of the park was a waterfall at Tenugu, where some of us jumped in for a swim. We learned how to make traditional pottery from a master potter and a female entrepreneur in the village of Say. We also enjoyed a local band performing in an open-air cabaret in Cotonou named Yes Papa. Jason actually joined the group on the keyboard for a few songs. At the end of the trip, we met with some Peace Corps volunteers. We explored the Cotonou craft market where we purchased some souvenirs and then went to the International Obama Festival Beach for a swim on our last day. This trip provided a unique view of how people in other parts of the world live. It was definitely one of the most impactful experiences that I've had at UNL in shaping my own worldview, learning about myself, developing these close friendships with the people that I traveled with, and as well as meaningful connections in a global network of the people that we worked with in Benin. We loved exploring the exciting and impactful work in the agricultural development and research happening in Benin. Through this trip, we now have a much more accurate picture of Africa, both its good aspects and its challenges, than the generally negative image of the continent that is usually portrayed by the media. I could talk about this trip all day, but I've learned that there are some things that you just have to experience for yourself. I encourage you to get back with Dr. Peterson, get some more information, and say yes to a game-changing experience that will shape your story.